revenge, and welcome to another episode of Bear Dub TV with me, your host, Doug from the Pinky Punk. It's going to be a super crazy show today, so grab your inflatable hippopotamus and follow me! Due to Holland's stringent copyright law, we are no longer allowed to use Eye of the Tiger as our intro music, but I think you're going to like the new one. Commissioned by someone entitled Little Known Urban Myths Debunked with Simple Yes and or No Answers. Hello, Doctor!
Oh.
Are you comfortable?
This for me is not usual with meat people.
It's okay, I'm wearing underwear.
My neck. It's not normal, it's looking.
Oh well, I'm afraid if we don't shoot this way, we'll be spooning, so hang on. Wow, what an amazing idea! I don't know why we didn't take the shoot this way earlier in the series. Are you more comfortable now, Doctor?
Actually, it's much more like
Please wait for the comical microphone to reach your face before you answer.
God!
I'm sorry! I'm not used to this new shooting arrangement! So, Doctor, can I say, you don't look very comfortable in the dub with me.
No, it's
just... It's okay. Perhaps if I explain the reason the Dutch people take badge, you will feel better.
If we are residing at unpatriotically high altitudes, we feel ill at ease, as though we were stranded on Valsjeburg. Being in the tub reminds us of the polders of our lowlands, such as the Haarlemmer Meer, in which the water level can be controlled manually.
This is actually a very intelligent show, you know. Whoa! I think it's time to get the otter out of the tub! There you go! Off to frolic in the tidal mudflats and bullfields to kiss the ghost of Wanji! Mwah! Well, I think we deserve a little treat. Cocoa butter bath foam?
No, thank you.
Shoot yourself. Anyway, on with our show. Our next question comes in... Hang on. I apologize, I really do. But at Baytown Television, we're obliged to squeeze a ducky every 5 minutes or so to keep the retarded distracted while they're getting their bath. It's a kind of community service, and it makes us feel good about ourselves. Plus, we also get paid for it, so, you know, what do you do? You do what you can, you know? Anyway, our next question comes in from Capable and Rapable 746. He asks, can kitten whiskers of dubious origin be woven together to make a rope strong enough to strangle a grown woman who loves her pets more than her family?
It's It's not so simple. It's a question with two answers, actually. It's
A dose answers. Yes and no?
Yes, yes.
Can you be more specific?
Nothing is more specific than yes or no.
Okay, well then actually leads us nicely onto a final question. It comes in from 5-year-old Hannah from Botswana. She asks, hang on. Shorty.
Retards again, eh?
Oh yeah, retards, who needs him, eh? Anyway, little Hannah writes, the name of your book is Little Known Urban Myths, debunked with simple yes and or no answers.
Nah, nah.
But she asks, is it possible to debunk a myth by giving it a yes answer? Would that not just be confirming the myth?
Who the fuck do you think you are?
Sure.
I remember when you were presenting your program in a cardboard box full of freezing water with a Russian accent. China remembers!
Cardboard part of the radio vision program with... I'm Dutch! I've gone out of my way to make that clear with my frequent and unprovoked references to Polish!
Yeah, yeah, whatever, whatever. I was not born with 17 nipples just to be embarrassed. Okay, this interview is over.
Oh! My cornflakes!
Fucking what this idea of all that great stuff.
Name, my beautiful cornflakes!
No! Oh! Faster!
It's gone. Still going to shit. Every time. Goes to... Oh, please, Willem. Willem the fire, don't look at me. It's gone to shit again. It's all gone to shit, Takish. It's all gone to shit. Turn on the damn camera! And now, Radio Vision Program! You'll end me! I've shit my job! Don't judge me, Takish. Please don't judge me. Fuck you, Takish! Realize this! Don't look at me, I've shit my job! Turn it off! Turn it off!
Adamantium.